My name is Mylène Boisvert and I am a textile artist based in Montreal. For this presentation, I will share with you some of my working process with paper yarn spinning through the project Les Saisons du Lin, which was inspired by three previous artworks, including Linen Field No. 2, which is a part of the present exhibition Spin, Twirl, Twist. In my practice, I work mostly with locally handmade linen paper that I transform into yarn. The first time I spin sheets of linen paper, I was captivated by the intrinsic qualities that the flax fiber retains despite undergoing successive transformations. Fabric scraps are first transformed into paper, which I once again transform into thread. And with that thread, I build structures that are loosely inspired by antique textiles. In 2011, I received an invitation to participate in the Biennale Internationale du Lin de Portneuf in Quebec. It was the perfect moment to put my first research with paper yarn into practice. It was also a nice technical challenge because I wanted to work on the composition of two large circles made of linen paper yarn that were going to be dressed for the large format photographs that were part of the exhibition. The making of that artwork gave me the opportunity to learn more about the rich history of flax growing in Quebec, and one of those stories is related to my family. My mother told me about her grandmother, Rebecca, who grew a flax field to supply her family with clothing as well as having sheep for wool. My family has kept a few of those toiles du pays. Following this biennial experience and soon after the making of Linen Field No. 1 and 2 that were presented at the Cambridge Gallery in 2014, I needed to follow up with other large-scale linen paper works on the linen theme, and I also wanted to highlight old textile works from my family archives and also those of friends who shared with me their own connection either to flax fiber or to the transmission of knowledge of a textile know-how. I was grateful for the story I was told and also for their generosity to share with me their textile archives so that I could draw inspiration from them in my work. I spent a lot of time analyzing the textile objects I received for that project. Small handkerchiefs, ribbons, and laces, most of which were crafted by generations of women long ago. Also, the contemplation of their different shapes, their ornamentation, and the intertwining of the threads gave me the desire to interpret them freely, that is to say, by modifying their composition a little and without using the same techniques. I also saw them in large format and hung on the wall so that one could make another reading of the initial utilitarian object. The collection Les Saisons du Lin includes large-scale works. It is made of kilometers of paper thread that I sometimes spin by hand, just with my fingers, or with the help of a tool such as a drop spindle or a spinning wheel. In fact, the paper thread that forms the work Linen Field No. 2, which is part of the present exhibition Spin, Twirl, Twist, was spinned with my thumb and forefinger, which actually gives a different quality to the yarn. Depending on the work I make, and according to the type of paper I use, I will switch from one spinning technique to another. The structures I create for the works are inspired by traditional methods without applying them. It is a way for me to play freely with paper as I did in my childhood. Playing with the material takes an important place in my practice, and I therefore form my own textile vocabulary. It allows me to better understand the paper material and to discover a little more of its potential for shaping. I let myself be guided by the paper, and I make decisions as I manipulate it and observe it. Also, when I install a new pattern on the wall, I never know how I will proceed to build the work. I do a lot of testing by manipulating the thread until I find a procedure I like. I always leave room for improvisation in the process, and the protocols are decided as the work is built. Each piece takes several months to complete, so it is a slow work, and for this collection, there are few colors. It took me a long time to integrate color into the yarn. Apart from the fact that the textile archives I received for this project were mostly of natural colors, another reason is that I wanted to focus on understanding the material and also start that repertoire of custom textile structures. The paper thread is the basis of most of the works, but I also like to go towards drawing on linen paper, which I execute either with a pen or with very small brushes. The medium I use for that are gouache, ink, or watercolor. The drawings are made with the same intention of documenting in my own way the textile archives, and it is also a way to take the time to appreciate the linen paper other than by cutting it to make thread. Also, during the development of this collection, I had the chance to participate in two other events related to linen. I participated in the Linen Biennale in Northern Ireland in 2018, and just before, in 2017, I made a trip to Upper Normandy, where I was invited for the Linen Festival, which has been going on for several years. I was able to see huge flax fields for the first time, and it was a great opportunity to meet the farmers and the various players in the flax industry in France. So this work, which has for title Abondance, is made of Normandy flax fiber that was given to me by the farmers. It takes different forms depending on where I have exhibited it, and the primary inspiration is the idea of the flax field, light, water, and abundance. Its first installation was designed for a small chapel attached to a castle in Normandy, and this other version on the photo was part of the exhibition at the McClure Gallery in Montreal in 2019. So to conclude, this collection took me about 4 years to make, and I don't conclude the project necessarily. I let myself still be guided by the conversations it generates. I learn a lot from the encounters I have regarding this collection, and they are an important contribution to the inspiration. The studio work is a very solitary one, but the connection with the community is taking an important place through the works. So that's it. Thank you for watching and listening. So thank you.